Hey y'all, it's a sad day in Alabama. As you can see behind me, the grass has gone dormant, which means me cutting grass is going dormant. So I figured before I put everything up and take it all down and clean it up for the winter that I do a little setup review on my part-time lawn cutting business, do a trailer and truck walkthrough, show you guys some of the things I ended up with. Some of the things that I started with. So, first thing I'll do is I'll show you what I keep in the back of the truck. And back here, I've got, let me open this up. I usually keep this stuff locked, but since it's been in my driveway for a week now, it's all unlocked. And I've got the little giant trailer right here, or the little giant ladder that I normally carry around with me. Also got some branches right there from God knows when. Bottle of water. And then I got the VP small engine fuel right here that I normally run in my weed eater and blower. Probably every other tank, I'll fill it up with that. Then I got some mixed fuel, regular fuel. And then towards the end of it, I actually picked up the SureCan, which that's a lifesaver having that and having a 5 gallon tank. I also got my safety glasses right there that I normally keep right back here just for, you know, to get to them real quick. Then over here, I'll show you all the trailer I got. I picked this trailer up at Tractor Supply. I think it was about, gosh, maybe right at 1,000. I picked it up. It's a real short trailer, maybe 4 foot by 8 foot. So, but it's all I need. I'm pulling it with, you see right here, I got the V6 Tacoma PreRunner. So I can't pull too much, so I kept the trailer small. Now coming over here, this is my cooler. I've got a Lifetime cooler I got from Walmart. It did a great job over the summer. I think the longest I went without having to change out ice was maybe 3 days, 2 days normally. We're right at the sweet spot. Then I got my signs right here that I got for my truck. Actually, I took these off maybe about 2 or 3 months into the summer because, you know, I was getting swamped, so I had to remove those. So I'm glad that I got the magnets so I could take them on and off. Then I usually keep this on the back of the trailer, especially if I'm doing any cleanup or landscape jobs. I got this Brute Rubbermaid right here. It does a great job. I mean, you can throw it around, you can lose it on the interstate and go back and get it. It'd be fine. Then moving into push mowers. So I got this Honda 170 right here that I keep on the back of my trailer just because I do a lot of hills in neighborhoods that have a lot of runoff hills that I got to get to. Actually, this is my second one I own this summer. I started out the business with this Honda mower, and then I sold it and got the Time Master. Then I sold the Time Master and got the Surfer Pro and went back with the Honda. And the thing I noticed with the Honda owning two different models the same summer is I always tend to break this little handle piece off right there. So that's really my only complaint with this mower. I mean, I throw this thing around, so it's no wonder that it broke a little bit. But, you know, for the price it is, it does a great job. I mean, it took some damage from me this summer. That Speedy Green I got sitting over there, I didn't really use too much. I just got that sitting in the trailer because I ran out of room in my garage. The masterpiece of this setup is going to be this 34-inch Surfer Pro I picked up maybe right in June or July. And man, I have loved this thing, especially for my residential yards. I mean, it makes it easy. Let's see, I think I ended up getting, yep, 90 hours on it. So again, I just cut part time in the mornings, afternoons, when I get done with my full time job. So 90 hours I got on that. Gosh, it's been great. I'm gonna put out a full review of it, goods and bads, but overall, highly recommend it. I put out a video and I was spraying grass all over somebody's flower beds, and comments ran me through the wood chipper. So I went out and got this ballard blocker, and man, that made a big difference. I can mulch, I can control when I shoot and when I don't. So I got that on there, and I'm also running the Ballard mulch blades. I'll show y'all in here in a second when I make my way over there. In front of the trailer, I got everything is equipment defender. So the weed eater rack right there, and then the blower. I got this PB770T Echo. Man, thing is a beast. I was running this steel BG50 right here. And again, I'm just doing residential yards. So you see my driveway. Driveway's just like that, you know, sidewalk, nothing big. But I started picking up some more properties that had a little bit bigger driveways. And you know, even though this works for these driveways, it just takes so long. So when I got this 770T right here, I mean, it started shaving 5-10 minutes off blowing at the end. So it made a huge difference, especially for when I'm running solo. That's all, basically all I do. It's a game changer. Then I started out with, and this is funny, I started out with this steel curved shaft FS40C, and it did good, but it started giving out on me probably 3 weeks in when I started doing a couple yards a day. It just was not keeping up. So I switched to another steel, the 56RC, which you don't see on the rack. And the reason is I switched to that steel and I burnt the carburetor up in it or something. And so it was still under warranty. So I took it to the steel dealership and I kept calling to check on it. They kept putting me off. And eventually I just gave up on it. I still hadn't heard back from it. I gotta, now that I'm talking about it, I've forgotten all about it. So it's been probably 3 or 4 months now. It's been at the dealer getting fixed. I got no idea what's going on with it. But you know, that was a bad taste in my mouth with steel, especially cause you know, that's the only dealer in my town that fixes them. So I ended up going to Echo for my weed eater because I had such a good time with the Echo blower. I went and bought this SRM 2620. Now I didn't get the T version, so I know that there's even an upgrade on this where you get the T and it has a faster head spin. So I'm looking forward, maybe even upgrading that coming up this next summer. Again, I got the Equipment Defender rack. Man, that thing right there is a lifesaver. I was putting everything in the back of my truck and I got this short bed. So the weed eater was hanging out, you know, this right here was hanging out, and it just wouldn't save, especially because folks can just lift that right out of the back of your truck. But with this, you got a little bit extra security. I mean, if somebody wants it, they're gonna take it, right? This right here is gonna be the buyer's weed eater cord holder. As you can see, I bent that. I ran into something, so I gotta fix that over the winter. But it's done a great job. I picked that up right at the end of the summer, and I wish I had gotten it at the very beginning, because I just come and prop the weed eater right here, put that string on, and I'm good to go. Again, I covered the steel BG50. It was great for what it did and getting me started. I ran the steel BG50, that 40C right there, and then that Honda mower. I ran that for about a month while I got my my yards up, and probably about the time I got you know, $400 or $500 a week I was making, and just spending hours and hours out there. I went with the Time Master, and that made a huge difference. Then I think I got to about $800-$900 a week, and then that's when I was spending a lot of time. My feet were hurting, my back was hurting. Actually the Time Master, you guys know, is heavy, so I had to get these right here. These are little ramps that I made with a ramp from Tractor Supply, and then some 2x6s, and I had to do that to get it on my truck. So I was getting whooped every day before I started my full-time job. So that's when I ended up getting the Hustler Surfer right there, and that changed everything. The other thing I'll comment on, I usually have this in the truck with me too, chained up, is this Echo CS400. Man, that's a good little chainsaw. Right there, it's dirty. I just used it right before we went out on vacation. I never got a chance to clean it, but man, that's a good little chainsaw. I've cut up limbs, cut up trees. I cut down a couple trees with it, so it's a good little chainsaw. Moving over here, this is my little corner in the garage for all my gear. I got this Husqvarna sprayer right here. It's just a hand pump because I had some acreage or maybe an acre that I was spraying on. So I went and got that. Man, I got these muck boots right here. Edgewater, the original muck boot company. Absolute lifesavers when it's because I cut mostly early morning when the dew's out and it's wet, and those things right there have saved my feet from getting swamped and getting blisters. So those are great little pickups. Over here in these drawers, I've just got odds and ends. I got some straps. There's my kids' lawn stuff, because you know they like helping their dad cut grass. I've got some weed eater attachments there. Hand tools. So a lot of stuff in there. Up here, I picked this Skill hedge trimmer up. Just it was on sale at Lowe's, so I got that. That thing's a beast. It's got that 40 volt in it, so it does a really good job. Nothing like a gas powered Steel or Echo, but for just every now and then jobs, you know, I keep this charged. I'll keep it in my truck with me and take care of it. Over here, I got some gloves. Got some chainsaw oil, chainsaw chaps. This right here is more residential that I use for my own yard. Here's the Ripper blades from Ballard that I started using when I got the Surfer Pro. And man, you put this Ballard blocker down just like it is right now, and with those blades, and it mulches the grass really good. So I don't have any complaints with that. You can see these are my old blades right here, and they got pretty beat up over the summer. Looking up here, there's my hat. Probably gonna need a new one on that next summer. There's my hat I got for buying the Surfer Pro. It's an expensive hat right there. Over here I got just some of the Honda mower stuff, and then under there I got some advertisements. So you know, overall, man, it was a great setup, I think, for what I was out here doing. Again, I was out here doing just part-time, mostly in the mornings. I think most times I started cutting grass about 6:30 in the morning, you know, making sure it was good with them and the neighbors. I didn't get any complaints. I'd cut till about 8 o'clock, and then I'd go do my full-time job. And then if I had yards left over, I'd cut after work, you know, till 6-7. But now I'm just focusing on any little odd jobs that come up. But like I said, I'm gonna be cleaning all this up and putting it up for the winter, and might make some upgrades coming up for the spring. But it's been a great time. I've made a good amount of extra money on the side doing it, and I've enjoyed it. So hey, thank y'all for watching. Check out the other videos. I'll be posting some more that I got some downtime that I took over the summer. So subscribe and you'll see those too. Thanks.